Hi guys, it's Jackson from Shot Caller Sports. Today I'll be recapping Game 1 of the Western Conference Semis between the Warriors and Lakers, as well as discussing Jordan Poole's controversial shot selection late in the last minute of the game, as this has become a recurring theme for people who watch the Warriors on a regular basis this season. I will also be giving a quick preview of tonight's Game 2 and insight into how Jordan Poole can possibly regain his form. So let's get into it. First, let's take a look at how both teams got here. The Warriors had an incredible seven-game series against the Sacramento Kings. Kings were up 2-0 to start the series, but the Warriors battled back and won three straight, leading to an eventual series-clinching win on the road, where they struggled all year. Game 7 was highlighted by Curry's epic performance, in which he dropped 50 points, the most in Game 7 history. He put the team on his back as he was not to be stopped in this finale. Just dicing up the Kings' defense on every possession, it felt like. The Lakers, on the other hand, had a relatively easier time handling the Grizzlies in their six-game series. They would go on to win the series 4-2 and win the clinching Game 6 by 40 points, thanks to this man right here.
Guangdong Tigers!
Ni hao! Ni hao! Ni hao!
Now let's take a look at some of the highlights from Game 1. As Wiggins started off the scoring, the three, it's nice to see him finally get going after his absence. Davis with a nice pull-up from free throw line. He's going to be key if the Lakers win the series. It was very back and forth to start the game as Poole hit a nice and one here before the half. Lakers were only up one at the half. The second half, things kind of changed. D'Lo kind of took over here. Tough step back. AR-15 here from the three. This is where the Lakers started to build a lead. The lead got up to as much as 14 in the fourth for the Lakers. But here is the play of the game, I think. Moody the rebound, tough beat behind the back by Klay Thompson, a nice dunk on AD's head by GP2. As you just saw, Poole, a nice pull-up three. AR-15 going to work here at the lob to LeBron. The Lakers pushed out the lead 14 again. But here's where things started to change in the Warriors' favor. Draymond Green, a block on Schroeder. Thompson pass ahead to Curry. Curry layup over LeBron, cut the lead to 6. As you see here, Poole, a nice pull-up three, wide open to cut the lead down to 3. And then Curry, on this play, almost set the arena on fire with this one. Nice pass to Green, pass back, 3 to tie the game. D'Lo here in the last minute and a half of the game, tough finish to the rim, push the lead to 2. Here is where the play in question occurs. As you can see, the Warriors are down 3 with only 22 seconds left. There's 4.5 left on the shot clock for LeBron, so all the Warriors have to do is just get the ball back and set up a good shot, but I'll just let the video speak for itself.
Himself a lot of time.
For 3, no! Curry with a rebound. Shot clock is off. Warriors down 3. Curry double team. Jordan Poole lets it fly. No! Long rebound.
This shot is controversial for a number of reasons. The first of which, if you notice the time on the clock, there is still 11 seconds left. That is more than enough time to set up a more effective and more high percentage shot. In the Warriors' offense, it revolves around pick and rolls and ball movement, which is why they lead the league in assists. If he just spins the ball around and finds, even if Curry can get open, then that is a much higher percentage shot. And while you could say that the Lakers could look to foul if Poole passes the ball, leading to a free throw shooting game which the Warriors would not win without a miracle, their defense did not look at all like they were going for this outcome. And even if he held onto the ball, at least pump fake and reload, the next closest defender after Jared Vanderbilt wasn't even in position to contest a possible shot. And still, if this goes in, there is at least 6 seconds left in the game, more than enough time for the Lakers to drive up the court and give AD, LeBron, AR-15, or even D'Lo a good look. People who are more than capable of hitting those game-winning shots. But this all goes back to the ball movement around the perimeter, something the Warriors are arguably the greatest team ever at. In those 11 seconds, they could damn near pass the ball around Chase Center and still have enough time to put up a good shot from 3. Poole has had a habit of ignoring players around him in Curry and Klay, and has been settling for extremely low percentage shots in situations that just aren't his to take. And it isn't the first time he's done that this year. In a game earlier this year against the Grizzlies, the Warriors had the ball and lead late in the game. With a missed shot, Poole got the ball back with a reset shot clock and a chance to run the offense and put the game away. Instead, he pulled up for a 35-plus foot shot and bricked it. Curry ended up getting ejected for his reaction to the shot, which led him to throw his mouth guard into the stands. You know you're doing something wrong when you make Curry react this way. In another situation this year, the Warriors were down late to the Pistons. Yes, the Detroit Pistons were beating the Warriors. Poole advanced the ball into the front court with more than enough time to take the final shot. Instead, he tries to ISO from the three-point line, trips and falls, and turns the ball over. The Warriors would go on to lose because of this. And more recently, in Game 6 of the first round against Sacramento, the Warriors got embarrassed this game, but no one more than Jordan Poole. I'm not even sure how to explain what he was trying to do. And while this was just one ugly mistake, it goes to show what this year has felt like watching him. Just watch the replay of this.
It's been that kind of game for Jordan Poole. Just 2 of 10 from the field.
Now, I don't want this to turn into a Poole hate video. I have been a supporter since his rookie year, and his progression as a player in his first 4 years since he came into the league at the age of 19 has been astronomical. It was more than evident already for us Warrior fans, but he put the world on notice during the 2022 playoffs, specifically the finals, which his highlights are playing in the back. His confidence and ability to knock down shots were incredible, which makes it confusing why this year he has seemingly taken a step back. After 2022, he signed a $128 million contract, which surpassed $145 million after incentives. At the time, this felt like a great deal, as he was now under contract for the 2027 season. However, this contract, listed at $27 to $30 million a year, puts him in contention with players like Donovan Mitchell, DeMar DeRozan, De'Aaron Fox, and even approaching Jason Tatum numbers. But since signing this contract, Poole's stats have declined. He has attempted more shots, while his field goal percentage has gone down, even for threes. His rebounding has decreased, and his turnovers have increased. His player efficiency rating, which measures most of the important statistics and averages them out, has also dropped. And don't get me started with his defense, as that has not improved much at all since rookie season. So in conclusion, yes, I think his shot against the Lakers was really bad. I think it reflected his performance for most of this year. However, I still think he can rebound from this. He is only 23 and has 4 more seasons left in his contract. More than enough time to develop under this system. And with the way the Warriors have developed other stars like Klay and Dre, I don't see why Poole can't regain his title of the third Splash Bro and eventually lead this offense in the post-Curry era. Which brings me to my advice for his career. Stop forcing things and learn your role. Curry is the quarterback of this offense and will remain so until retirement. If Poole stops pushing transition so much and look for the open look more, he will see his shot selection open up and become more effective. Curry isn't just good because of his shooting. He does it with his off-ball movement and ability to create looks for other people. As for Game 2, expect the Warriors to put more of a focus on AD or Anthony Davis. I think it was surprising to see LeBron off-ball so much, but that's what happens with age and a young core. If they could wear out AD and LeBron, this series becomes so much more simplified. However, people besides Curry need to score as well if the Warriors want to win. This includes Jordan Poole.
Hooray!
We'll be right back.